Now, I didn't know that volcanoes existed on other planets and not just Earth. Tell us about that.
Well, actually, it's not just the planets. It's even the moons around planets. And the most spectacular one would be the moon Io. That's the smallest of the four Galilean moons. They're the moons that Galileo observed when he turned his telescope towards the planet Jupiter back in the early 1600s, and he discovered to his amazement that it had moons orbiting it. And Io orbits every 2 to 3 days. It's quite close to Jupiter and it orbits rapidly, but it has the most amazing volcanic activity. One of the space probes imaged a volcano there called Loki, which was ejecting material 400 kilometres above the surface of the moon. This is a phenomenally violent little moon going around Jupiter. You know, it's only about a quarter the size of the Earth, and yet it dissipates far more heat than our planet does. So people are amazed, where is it getting all this energy to keep all this massive volcanism going for billions of years? So there have been a number of ideas put forward. One is through tidal dissipation. Now, what that means is when a moon is very close to it, particularly a large planet like Jupiter, the gravitational fields across that planet are so strong that they actually distort the moon so it's somewhat bent out of shape. It's a bit like a football rather than a sphere.
Okay.
And as it rotates, it's constantly being stretched and pulled and stretched and pulled. And they think maybe that's the source of the energy which is going into producing these volcanoes on Io. The trouble is, when you do the numbers, that only accounts for about 1/10 of the total energy needed for Io's volcanism.
So it's actually not enough energy to explain the magnetic field.
Nowhere near it. So where's the other 9/10 coming from? There have been some ideas. People have thought, well, maybe the mountains on Io have been somehow or other subducted and then it comes back out as fresh volcanic eruptions. But that's a fantastic explanation. It's a very long bow to draw. In fact, that cyclic process would have happened over 100 times in the life of the little moon, which is exceedingly unlikely. So there's no really viable explanation for the incredible source of energy that Io has. But there is one. Maybe it's not billions of years old. Maybe it's only thousands. Can you see how changing the glasses with which we look at the evidence opens up the possibility of a very elegant and simple explanation? Now, it's not just Io. There's also a volcano on an asteroid.
An asteroid.
Now, this is an object which is not orbiting close to a planet. It's orbiting the sun. It's in the asteroid belt. It's the largest of the asteroids, in fact, called Ceres. So on this asteroid Ceres is a huge volcano called Ahuna Mons. And it's producing eruptions. It's a cryovolcano, so it's very cold, but nonetheless, material is flowing out of it. And scientists are perplexed. What is the source of heat that is activating the movement of all these materials? And the lead scientist said, frankly, we don't know the answer. So it's one of those unguarded moments, if you like. Now, there's nothing wrong with the scientist not knowing the answer. Don't misunderstand me, because that's the thing which fuels the passion of inquiry and wanting to discover the answer. But what he's really saying is, in code, there is no answer that is consistent with our paradigm, our framework of billions of years. But if you allowed yourself to think in terms of thousands of years, well, there's no problem at all. So there are so many different illustrations like this that we can find of processes which are happening that should not be happening if the billions of years were true.
So for people who are interested in this topic, there is a documentary which delves into cosmology, which I think you, Mark, were a part of.
Yes, I was. It's called Evolution's Achilles' Heels, and it looks at 8 different topics to do with this whole debate on origins. And there's a section in there on cosmology and looking at the origins of the universe. It's a marvellous documentary. It's an award-winning one, and I recommend that people get a hold of it, because it's just jam-packed full of vital information.
We'd love to make that available to you for a free 7-day stream. The link will be in the description.